is no problem, but bagel, I have a problem. I, as a dentist, you know, we have a problem like gum diseases, which Prabha just mentioned.
Right.
But we have a major problem of dental cavities. And yes. Bagel is like a bread. And if you right. see bread is, you know, it's not sticky here, right. but when mixed with saliva, it becomes a little sticky. And it stays on the mouth, and the carbohydrates breaks into sugar, and that sugar is a problematic issue. And that sugar breaks into glucose and maltose. And if that sticks on the tooth surface, well, you have to face for the cavities. God.
No, that doesn't sound very good at all. You just made me feel even more guilty about having that bagel than I did this morning. But Doc, I want to ask you, so this is pretty serious because my husband, being an athlete, okay. obviously has a really strict eating and exercise regime, but he's quite a bit of a sweet tooth. So he loves his donuts and his chocolate cake, and I know already what you're going to say to me. I can see it coming.
But you know, we love these patients who eat chocolates and donuts and all. You know, but when I entered in the morning, I went for a breakfast, and right. the same thing was there. You have a donut,
yeah.
a donut with chocolate. We got a donut with sugar, and we got a pastry also. Now, all these things contains, of course, I spoke about glucose and maltose, but it also contains sugar in the form of sucrose. So we got one more sugar in the form of sucrose, which is dangerous. There were pastries also, which is also sticky, and is quite dangerous. And I saw sandwiches. Now, you say sandwiches is good, but the no. bread is sticky. It sticks on the tooth surface, and again, because, sucrose. I mean, maltose and glucose. So everything contains some sort of sugar. And then when you go for a break for a coffee, we have a cookie.
Cookies.
And this cookie also contains glucose and maltose. But besides that, there are different types of cookies. And if you see this cookie.
Yeah, those are my husband's favorite.
Yeah. And what is there? White. White is, of course, a dairy product. And it is lactose in the form of sugar. Now, again, there is a sugar, sugar, and sugar. And that is dangerous for the tooth. And it causes cavities.
I know exactly what you're saying, Doc. So as a mom now, uh-uh. I've tried to keep my daughter away from sugar for as long as possible.
How old is she?
But she's 2 years, 4 months now. She started going to birthday parties. Uh-huh. And like all kids, she goes straight for the birthday cake and the chocolates and the candies. And it's becoming increasingly difficult keeping her from them. I mean, it's
I can understand. You know, most of the parents, it's very difficult. And especially grandparents, it's difficult to keep
Completely.
Children away from the chocolates. But, you know, you've got chocolates in two forms. One is yeah. this chocolate, which is sticky, and one are candies.
Please tell me
now,
there's
the
a healthy chocolate.
Chocolate is more dangerous than this candy because chocolate is sticky. It sticks on the tooth surface. And it contains sucrose, which is a heavy sugar. And that, again, is a dangerous part. This is okay, but it melts in the mouth. But again, it's heavy sugar. And when I say heavy sugar, you know, when you start a car, sure. you require this much petrol or this much petrol.
Right.
Similarly, whether you got one candy or small chocolate or a big bunch of chocolate, sugar is sugar and it starts
I
the cavity
that.
Formation.
I get that. But Doc, there has to be, I mean, there has to be healthy foods that we eat every day as well, right? That combat, I mean,
you
in
know,
some
you're talking
way,
about
conflict.
Day, but there are parties also. As
sure.
you mentioned about children party, but
right.
there's elder parties.
Yes.
And when you go for elder parties, well, we have soft drinks, we have chips.
Right.
And chips are there for children also.
For sure.
Now, chips sound very brittle when I break here, but when it mixes with saliva, right. it is so sticky that it doesn't go with the rinsing of your mouth also. So this is another culprit because this, what is it, soft drinks or wines, what you have, contain acid. It develops, you know, your saliva becomes acidic.
Jesus.
Again, this gives acid. Again, glucose and maltose. And again, you have cavities.
Oh,
so
God.
Cavities all along because of sugar acids.
But
and
we
sugar
have healthy food also, Doc, that combats. No, that doesn't combat. Like, I mean, dalia and rotis and...
Rotis are okay. But if you talk about pastas and pizzas
pasta.
And noodles, well, no way. They're sticky and that's going to create a problem.
I have to stop cooking at home. What am I going to feed
well.
Fruit.
Well.
I'll feed them fruit.
Okay. You
else?
Talked about fruit, I've got two.
Oh, no.
Now, you know, we say apple a day keeps doctors away, but we as a dentist say that apple a day keeps dentists closer to you. You know why? Because apple also is little sticky sticks on the tooth surface.
Right.
And then one more fruit which your husband really loves is banana.
Yeah, he's got it courtside with him
yeah, because
all
you see,
the time. It's
all,
energy.
Yeah. All the tennis players, you have bananas in between.
Right.
And also children.
Yeah.
You know, it's a stable diet.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, this banana contains fructose, like your apple.
Right.
And the fructose is also a sugar. And banana is very sticky. So the biggest advice is that for small children, if you're giving banana and milk, see that you rub your teeth, because all these acids in the form of sucrose in chocolates, maltose and glucose in biscuits and cookies and other things, and then you've got fructose in this and sucrose in chocolate. So all these sugar acids, and this is acid which caused the problem.
Oh God. Okay, so Doc, we've been, you heard it already on stage, and I pretty much grew up as a Colgate household. I mean, I think we used Colgate right through from the time I was a child, and I've been brushing my teeth. And, I'm inculcating the habit in my daughter to brush twice a day. She brushes in the morning, she brushes before she
goes
to
habit.
Bed. But if there's these kind of sugar acids in the mouth, Doc, I mean, how... what can you do then?
Okay.
I mean, what
let
is it going to cause?
Let me
what is going to be
you,
the...
Let me explain to you how the sugar acids... Let me see on the slides the sugar acids, you know. Well, your mouth contains saliva. This is sugar acid is the main cause.
Right.
The saliva, and when you eat, the saliva pH goes down. And when the pH goes down, we got sugar acids and bacteria. And these bacteria, we strive on these sugar acids, creates an acidic medium, and anything acid can eat away something. As far as tooth is concerned, the calcium and phosphate comes out of the tooth. And the balance is not there. Saliva is good. It brings back the calcium and phosphate on the tooth surface. But too much of sugar acids can create imbalance. And that imbalance, a lot of things come out. And then what we see is a formation of a cavity. And then that takes away enamel, takes away dentin, and you see the dark area is a cavity. And that cavity is irreversible. There's only in dental cavities are the only cavities which are irreversible. You can do pranayama and say diabetes can go down. You can do pranayama and say, your blood pressure goes down. But cavity filling is never taken place.
Right.
So you have to be careful of the sugar acids.
But Doc, as a mom, I know right from the start, from the time your child actually starts developing even her milk teeth, cavities just becomes one of the biggest banes of your life because you're constantly trying to fight this battle.
Yes.
So by the looks of it, there's no food that's going to actually prevent them from forming. So what is it?
Usually
is
I say,
done?
That if you want to avoid dental decay,
right,
you have to eat through your nose.
Well, that's one
that's
form of
one.
Yoga.
But then if you can, like sugar acid creates a low pH.
Right.
And we have fluoride in the the toothpaste all the time. But fluoride can protect the tooth after the acid attack takes place. But if there's any innovation by anybody which will stop these sugar acids and neutralizes that in the mouth, of course, the
right.
sugar acid which are there sticking on the plaque is a very sticky substance on the tooth surface
right.
where the bacteria goes in, sugar acid goes in,
right.
you form a cavity. But the sugar acid is neutralizes by anything.
Right.
I think we, the dental profession, will be very happy because you are preventing the dental decay. And instead of eating through your nose,
right.
you can eat through your mouth,
oh,
brush twice a day,
that'll always
but
be nice.
Prevent dental decay. Yeah.
So if that kind of a major breakthrough has to happen, Doc, in the dental world,
yes.
I mean, this takes care of a hell of a lot, not just for mothers, but for basically your entire, the health of your family, your own oral hygiene.
You can eat whatever is on this table. You can eat
right.
everything. And think of that, okay, I will not have dental cavities.
That's fantastic.
If I take care of sugar acid, which are dangerous.
That's fantastic.
I think that's a very important aspect.
So that's what you're looking for as a dentist, and that is exactly what Colgate has done and has innovative on. So I'd like to thank both of you for
thank
that
you
very
much.
Interesting session. I'm sure we all learned a lot. It was an eye-opener for all of us. So thank you, Lara, and thank you, Dr. Mayakar. Lara will definitely be up on stage again for that photo opportunity. Colgate Maximum Cavity Protection plus Sugar Acid Neutralizer, a breakthrough technology, a breakthrough in oral care. I'd now request Ms. Prabha Parmeshwaran, Dr. Mayakar, and Ms. Lara Datta on stage, please. And can they please be joined with Dr. Shashank Potnis and Dr. Doble? So we'd like to definitely capture this very special moment. Photographers, you are now allowed to come forward. Thank you. Thank you, photographers. We'll now open up the floor. Okay. Thank you, Lara, so much. We will now open up the floor to, or not, in 2 seconds.
With it, always, please. With it. Is this beautiful smile? Okay.
Okay, thank you, Laura. So, ladies and gentlemen, we will now open the floor to question and answers, and I'd like to hand the session over to Deepshika Dharmraj from Genesis Burse and Marsteller, who will moderate the session. So over to you, please.
Thank you so much. If the photographers are done with the... Okay, last couple of those. Yeah. Okay, so I will now request the photographers to please go back. You will get another opportunity after the Q&A. I would open up the floor for any questions that you have. May I please request you to ask your questions specifically on this launch?
Okay.
We have our spokespersons on the stage who will be very happy to answer any of your questions. I have colleagues who have mics, so please, if you can raise your hand, introduce yourself. Tell us who your question is directed at.
Here, left, yeah.
There, at the back, can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi, this is Zuhair from Pro Bollywood.
Hi.
So Lara, since you're a public figure and being a Bollywood celebrity, people follow you like anything. Whatever you say, whatever you speak, it makes the news. So when it comes to endorsing a product, coming up to support a product, like how conscious are you about the credibility of the product?
Well, I have been associated with Colgate before, and whoever has ever followed my career in any which way know that I associate myself with very, very few products. Like I said up here earlier, I've been a Colgate household for as long as I can remember. And if there is a name that I trust, I don't think any of us really need to be introduced to Colgate ever, because it's a household name in our country. I think it's fantastic. It's a name that you also trust when they do have breakthroughs, when they do have innovations. You know, there are innovations constantly and breakthroughs constantly in the field of medicine and medical technology and science. So why not dentistry? You know, and I think one of the pioneers of this has always been Colgate. So as a mom, as a wife, the health of my family is my utmost, you know, of importance to me. And I think dentistry is one part that we overlook quite a bit. It's, I mean, we've all discussed today that we, you know, we're constantly battling cavities and root canals and things like that, but it's so overlooked, and it's also one of the most expensive, you know, medical procedures
but
that you can go through.
Expensive.
No, so I would, yeah, but I would much rather have prevention rather than cure, and so it's fantastic to really be able to associate with a product like this.
Hello.
Okay, we have a gentleman in front. Can you give him the mic, please, Tanisha? That's Farooq Jasawala.
Farooq.
Good afternoon. Question, general question, of course, but then Colgate being Colgate, I suppose there is no two ways about it to ask certain things. But this was a prominent thing for the sugar acid, this product, and I think that is the biggest enemy so far as you have diagnosed. Now, we have always been concentrating on the food products, because they go into the cavities and they remain, and this has to be cleared. And of course, at the last, we came across the what is known as cold drinks, the soft drinks or whatever, which contain the maximum sugar as far as
acidity. Yeah.
Yes, of course, doctor, that was emphasized there. But do you think then this being the major factor, does it remain on our teeth? And if it is so, immediately after the cold drinks, we could brush the teeth and have it go?
So what happens when you have cold drinks? Cold drink contain acid, they are acidic basically. So your saliva pH goes down, and then you're eating chips or anything else. Again, you get a sugar acid which is on the tooth. So basically the pH goes down, and that pH is causing problem as a cavity. But if you brush and if you remove that part and make your mouth little alkaline by having water and then having the sugar acid neutralizer, then the cavity formation can reduce. It's not going to totally stop, but it will reduce the formation of cavity. So basically we are attacking the pH of your mouth, which is very important. So every time you eat, after eating you have water that neutralizes the saliva pH. But what happens to the pH on the tooth surface? That has to be taken care of. And the expert can also tell you that when you brush with this neutralizer, the research has been done that a pH is always go down, neutralizes because of this neutralizing product which is having in.
I think I just want to add
on this.
Please.
I just want to add here, I think I agree with Dr. Mayekar. I think nature has gifted us saliva, which is already in a dynamic, it always remains dynamic. So what happens is that whenever you eat or drink something acidic, saliva do take care of the acidity. However, what happens when you get food items within, in your oral cavity, getting stuck to within your teeth, then what happens, it becomes difficult to remove that, and that remains there, and that gets fermented. And that is something where this sugar acid neutralizer technology works. And once it starts working, once you brush with that, I think, as I've already mentioned about the kind of technology and how it works, the arginine, which is amino acid, along with the arginolytic bacteria, they work and create alkaline solutions, and then make this particular entire acidity neutralized. So this works in addition to the natural mechanism which has been created in our body metabolism. So.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
It means the same thing. We have to brush our teeth even after the cold drinks. That helps.
Cold drinks, brushing means to neutralize this thing. Yes. Even if you have water, it's fine. Cold drinks. They're not eating anything.
Cold waters.
I just want to add a little bit here. The cold drinks only is acidic, can cause a cavity on the surface without decay. But food habits and cold drink can cause cavity which becomes which is a dark in color. That's a real decay. Okay. So there are two types of cavities.
Thank you so much, Faruk. Please allow somebody else to ask a question. Yeah, thank you so much.
Hi. Yeah. Lara ji, mera aapse prashn ye hai ki aap model, actor, sab kuch hain, to aap apne matlab ki daanton ka khayal kaise rakhti hain aur cavity ne kabhi aapko pareshan kiya kya?
फिलहाल थैंक गॉड अभी तक मैं किसी डेंटिस्ट के पास कैविटी के लिए नहीं गई हूँ, कैविटी केयर के लिए नहीं गई हूँ. बट ऑफ कोर्स फ्रॉम द टाइम आप संजय माइकल जी जो हमारे साथ हैं यहाँ पे, एवरीबॉडी नोज हिम, यू नो वी हैड, ही इज बीन पार्ट ऑफ द मिस इंडिया ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर अस फॉर मेनी 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 इयर्स. एंड यू नो ही आई मीन फॉर अस आर डेंटिस्ट, for me, I know that my dentist who I go to is really, somebody that I treasure in my life. also because I want to have the most pain-free treatment possible.
whether cavity or no cavity, you have to visit a dentist because to maintain oral hygiene. Like you service your vehicle, car, आप जो कार को सर्विसिंग के लिए देते हैं, वैसे मुंह का सर्विसिंग जरूरी है, because you eat solid, liquid, acidic, alkaline, soft, anything you eat. तो उसका सर्विसिंग करना बहुत जरूरी है. तो उसके लिए तो डेंटिस्ट के पास मेंटेनेंस के लिए जाना बहुत जरूरी है. जैसे लारा जी ने जो बताया कि एक्सपेंसिव है, इट इज नॉट एक्सपेंसिव प्रोवाइडेड यू टेक केयर. कैविटी नहीं हो जाएगी तो एक्स खर्चा है, कैविटी हो गई तो 2x है, कैविटी और निगलेक्ट की तो रूट कैनाल 10x, उसके ऊपर कैप कराना 50x, इम्प्लांट करे तो और x. तो इट्स बेटर टू मेंटेन बाय रूटीन हाइजीन एट होम एंड विजिटिंग अ डेंटिस्ट फॉर मेंटेनेंस.
And doc, if I can say so, that for me personally, I always feel every 6 months is great to do a checkup.
Yeah.
And I've already taken my 2-year-old daughter to a dentist just to make sure that all her milk teeth and everything are fine. But it starts at that age. So she's already been, that was very difficult keeping her in the dentist chair, I have to say. But it starts at that age.
Hello. Yeah. डॉक्टर, मेरा सवाल ये है कि ये जो कोलगेट का आपने अभी लॉन्च किया, ये सिर्फ बच्चों के लिए है या किसी भी एज ग्रुप के लोगों के लिए?
क्वेश्चन बहुत वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. बच्चे लोग को कैविटी होती है, ग्रैंड मदर को भी कैविटी होती है. कैविटी होने का कारण एक ही है कि फूड पार्टिकल्स जो दांत के ऊपर रहते हैं उसके शुगर एसिड होती है, कैविटी होती है. जब आप ओल्ड हो जाते, जब एज हो जाता है, तो मसूड़े नीचे जाते हैं, मसूड़े नीचे जाने की वजह से फूड पार्टिकल्स रह जाते हैं और वहाँ हम रूट कैरीज, जैसे डॉक्टर शानबाग ने जब डॉक्टर पोतनी से जब बताया कि रूट कैरीज हो जाते हैं, तो बच्चे लोग को कैविटी दांत के ऊपर होते हैं और बूढ़े लोगों को कैविटी रूट कैरीज जैसे बोलते हैं वहाँ होते हैं। तो कैविटी फॉर्मेशन सबके लिए है, फ्रॉम पीडियाट्रिक टू जीडियाट्रिक। एंड एक बार कैविटी होगी तो फिलिंग करना डैमेज, एक बार इनेमल गया तो गया जिंदगी भर के लिए, तो उसको प्रिवेंट करना बहुत जरूरी है।
या लारा, या दिस इज राज फ्रॉम मीडिया, लाइक टू आस्क यू, डू यू यूज द ब्रांड यू प्रमोट?
यस, वेरी मच सो। I definitely use the brand, and at times when I'm traveling, my husband refuses to use anything else. So I'm on a hunt for Colgate, no matter which country that I go to. And this is irrevocably, whether I'm here for this product launch or not, this is the irrevocable truth. And I truly, genuinely believe in the brand Colgate.
Any more questions?
Any more? If not, then thank you so
much.
Go ahead.
Yeah, there is somebody who raised their hand. Yeah.
There. Okay.
Dr. Dhoble, I want to ask you, how would you promote oral care?